Cross-site scripting is one of the most common web security vulnerabilities. During this video, we see what an XSS attack is and why websites are vulnerable to this attack. Then we look at the different types of this attack and how attackers deliver and execute XSS against the application users. We also see what an attacker can do by exploiting this vulnerability. Then we proceed by exploiting a simple XSS in a vulnerable website. And finally, we learn how to prevent XSS in web applications. Cross-site scripting attacks, also called XSS, are a type of injection attack that targets the end user of web application, and therefore is a client-side attack. XSS allows an attacker to use vulnerable application to deliver malicious JavaScript code to the different users of the application. If an attacker successfully exploits XSS, then he would be able to compromise the user account and get access to user data and application functions. And if the victim of the attack is an admin user on the vulnerable application, then XSS could lead to fully compromise of application data and functionalities. Web applications often accept user inputs via HTTP requests and use this data to perform some actions or save them in the application database. If a website does not process the received data properly, then an attacker could inject malicious JavaScript code into the HTTP request and submit that request to the application, therefore manipulate the application behavior to deliver the JavaScript code to the other users. The user browser receives the HTTP response from the website and executes the injected code within the application response in the context of user session and triggers the XSS attack. There are three main types of cross-site scripting attacks: reflected, stored, and DOM-based cross-site scripting. Reflected XSS is the basic type of this attack. In the reflected cross-site scripting, the application receives user data containing malicious code from an HTTP request and includes that data in the immediate HTTP response to the user without performing robust process on the received data. In stored XSS, the application stores the attacker malicious code into the database, and later when any end user visits the vulnerable page, the application retrieves the attacker malicious code from database and delivers that code within HTTP response to the user browser, which gets executed within the context of user session. DOM-based XSS is different to the other types, and it happens when the application uses the untrusted data to write to the document object model without processing the received data. Unlike reflected and stored cross-site scripting, the DOM-based XSS exists in the client-side code rather than the server-side code. If an attacker exploits XSS in a vulnerable website, then he would be able to access or modify all the data that the victim user has access to, perform any actions on the application on behalf of the victim user, capture valid session cookies and hijack the user account, perform website defacement, capture the victim user login credentials, and retrieve CSERF tokens. Now let's see a simple stored XSS in action. For the purpose of this exercise, we use the first stored XSS lab from Web Security Academy. You can find the link to this lab in video description. Since this is a basic XSS, we only use a web browser, and we don't need any security testing tools. Let's begin by clicking on Access the Lab. From the homepage, we choose a blog post and click on View Post. As we can see, the page contains a blog post and comments from other users. Since we are looking for XSS vulnerability, we need to figure out how the application processes the user inputs. Let's fill the comment box using a simple string along with two special characters. Then we fill out name, email, and website fields. After providing all required data, we click on Post Comment. Now that our comment is submitted, we go back to the blog post. Looking at the comment section, we see the comment that we just posted. We right-click on this comment and choose Inspect to open Developer's Tools. Looking at the comment inside HTML, we see the application has not encoded the comment and has returned it unmodified. Since the application does not encode the user comments before including them in HTTP response, this would allow users to inject JavaScript code in the comment field. Now let's post another comment. This time we use a simple JavaScript code. This code will display an alert box with the message 1. I fill out the other fields and post a comment. Our new comment is submitted. Now we go back to the blog post, and as we see, the injected JavaScript code is executed by the web browser and a new window pops up. Since our comment is stored in application database, every time a user visits this page, the application returns the JavaScript code and it will be executed in the user's browser. Although this was a simple stored XSS, it shows how an attacker can exploit XSS vulnerability to manipulate the application to return malicious JavaScript code to its users. There are two main defensive mechanisms that protect a web application against cross-site scripting attacks: input validation and output encoding. In order to implement a robust input validation, the application should follow some basic rules. All received data, including user input, HTTP headers, HTML form inputs, and query strings, should be treated as untrusted data. Therefore, the web application should perform strict data validation on all received data to ensure that they only contains the expected value. Input validation must be conducted on server side and avoid relying on client-side input validation. An attacker can easily bypass client-side input validation using a proxy tool or even a simple web browser extension. Output encoding is the main defensive mechanism against cross-site scripting attacks. The purpose of output encoding is to convert untrusted data into a safe form that ensures they would be treated as data and not an active element of HTML or JavaScript context, therefore preventing code execution in the user web browser. When implementing output encoding, the application should encode user data before including them into the HTTP response. The application should determine the context of user data in the HTTP response and use the relevant encoding method, including HTML, JavaScript, and CSS encoding. Further to these defensive mechanisms, there are other options that can help to reduce the risk of XSS attacks: using appropriate HTTP response header and enabling content security policy. If the HTTP response does not contain active contents such as JavaScript or HTML, then X content type and X content type option headers should be used to instruct the web browser to interpret the response as data. So if an attacker managed to inject malicious JavaScript code into the application, it won't be executed in the user web browser, therefore reducing the risk of XSS attacks. Content security policy is a browser security mechanism that restricts the active resources that a web page can load. CSP is enabled by adding content security policy HTTP response header. CSP should be configured to only allow scripts and images from same origin or trusted external domains. If an attacker managed to manipulate the application to return the malicious JavaScript code to the users, then content security policy could prevent XSS exploitation in the user web browser. CSP should only be used as an extra defensive layer and never be trusted as the only defensive mechanism, since an attacker might be able to bypass it using policy injection techniques. I hope you enjoyed watching this video, and I'll see you in the next videos.